Welcome to the Macroeconomic News. I'm your anchor, the Raziel, and bringing the news straight from my forehead to yours. Our top story today. There's something happening on the 22nd, and that thing is Neomagius stuff. Yes, it's Neomagius stuff. That's our headline today. There's a Neomagius banner with Shigohago, and this one. Now, as far as we know from the story, or as far as we knew from the story, Joan had absolutely no connection to Neomagus whatsoever, but she's on the Neomagus banner, which I guess the banner just spoiled us that in the story she's gonna join Neomagus. So yeah, thanks banner for, I guess, spoiling that. Unless it's like a misdirection and she doesn't actually join them, but something else happens. But yeah, that's at least made people scratch their foreheads for a bit. However, there's something more important that is going to happen on the 22nd. It's Mitsune. So Mitsune from the Ghost in the Hood event, which I'm going to make a video about at some point. Maybe soon. I've already got another video lined up, but Mitsune is coming, and she looks kind of, how would you say, kind of weary. Maybe a little bit more, you know, kind of evil than before, I don't know. Because she, in the Ghost in the Hood events, she seemed kind of, she looked 10 years younger than this, for some reason. Like, she looked like he's aged like 10 years in the 2 years that actually passed in the game. Like, especially right here, look at that, isn't that some sort of like evil grin, evil face right here? She's not supposed to be like that. What did they do to you, Mitsune? What did they do to you? What happened? We're gonna have to find out, because there's story to go along with it. It's the Neomagius event, the Pendants Blue, with two new other characters. One of them is called Miori. I don't know what the other one is called. One of them did something. I'll just say that you should probably keep Chiharu away from them, well, otherwise Chiharu might have a really bad day. I'm just gonna very quickly talk about the event before I go back and talk about Mitsune as a unit. So this is the Neomagus event. It talks about Neomagus because they didn't actually have an event or anything else yet. They've just had some stuff in main story. So this event would be a boss type event, so it's kind of like Tarot and Kazumi, where you just fight some dudes in some wave battles and then you fight big bosses, 8 of them or whatever, and then you fight a giant big boss at the very end. I mean, the usual. There's one, of course, one of the memoria going to be from the gacha. It gives you a drop bonus, and one memoria that comes from the event drop, giving you a bonus. And the usual stuff, the usual stuff. Now, I haven't translated the stuff in here yet, but I assume it's similar to the other boss event they recently held. What will happen is probably that the challenge nodes in that event, the challenge nodes will probably be blue auto-enabled, but the regular nodes probably not, I don't know. But yeah, they should at least have the blue auto enabled for the challenged quests, at least. But going back to, by the way, there's another piece of news. People once again cheated in mirrors and they got their points deducted, of course. That happens every single time, every single rank mirrors. So talking a little bit about the Mitsune, if you want to hear a little bit about her unit, like what does she actually do? I don't know if she's limited or unlimited, but guess what, guys? She has charge conservation, or as someone in chat has said, charge conversation. So she can converse to other people about charge, and what she has is first off her connect. Her connect gives charge conversation, so they can talk to people about charge. It gives charge damage up, and it gives like attack up, regular attack up, right? Let me double check with my notes. Yes, indeed, that's what it does. I don't want to say anything wrong. No, she's a charge gorilla. Let me check the translation. Yeah, she's a charge gorilla. She's a support type, which you could kind of see from her stats being terrible. And it says support right here. I mean, that also gives it away. But just by her stats being terrible, you can kind of tell. But like I said, stats usually don't matter much for supports anyway, because they're supposed to have some cool effects they give to other people. And charge conversation is definitely a really good one. Moving on, though, what else does it do? Well, she has a Magia. The Magia doesn't give charge conservation, but maybe her Doppel, because it's possible. Like, you know that, especially recently, characters get a lot more effects on their Doppel, possibly gets charge conservation on Doppel as well. But yeah, what does the Magia actually do? Well, it does AoE damage. Never mind, it deals single target damage, I misread. It does attack up to all allies, as you would hopefully expect from a support that you would have an effect like this, so attack up to all allies. That already makes her quite decent, although she is a charge gorilla, so she wouldn't get to Magia that easily, unless you use charge conservation for Excels, which you could do. And it gives something different. This says charge attack resistance down to target. Or rather, I think right here what this says is charge damage taken up by enemies. So this seems to be a new effect. I haven't seen this yet. I have no idea. But I guess it's just kind of like a charge up, where like a charge up effect that you would usually have, the Red Sea effect. What that is that when someone has a charge point, at least one charge point, and they spend at least one charge point on an Excel disk or a blast disk, that Excel or blast disk gets increased by however much charge up you have, right? Like 20% charge up. That means if you use at least one charge disk on a blast disk, that blast disk will gain an additional 20% damage. And this seems to be the same effect, just that instead of your character having that and attacking the enemy and then getting the bonus, it's just the enemy has that as a debuff, and then whoever attacks that enemy with at least one charge point being spent will get that effect. Which seems to be way better than just charge up in most cases. I say most cases because this is a single target Magia. If this was AoE Magia, it would always be better, but with this being a single attack Magia, you inflict one enemy on that, and let's say, for example, you have two different enemies hitting the enemy that has that. Both of those enemies don't need to both have charge up to get the bonus. You just need it on the enemy, and then both of them are going to get the bonus. I'm going to need to look into this more when the character comes out and I can actually do a how good video on them, because I need to look into how this actually plays out. Maybe I need to find someone who is going to roll for her. It's going to be difficult to help me out a little bit, because last time I actually did have someone help me out with Tsuruno and Felicia, because I wanted to do some testing on how fire attack up worked, so I had someone do some testing with me, someone who wrote the character, on how that worked out. But yes, that's the Magia. The active is just charge conservation for self, okay. Then some of the passive is just charge combo charge count up plus 3, okay. Then some other passive is charge disc damage up and charge damage up for self, okay. Pretty good bonuses actually. And the other one is light damage up 5%. Okay, she's not going to do that much damage unless you like specifically play her as like someone who uses her charge discs for blasting, then sure. But I think what you would actually do is if you use her charge conservation active on herself, you probably want to use those on Excels. Because I assume her Doppel is going to give some cool stuff, right? Her Doppel might give charge conservation to either herself or to multiple people, we don't know. But if her Doppel is really good, I mean, she's a support. She's not really going to do that much damage compared to someone like Sister Momoko, who's like an attacker who definitely deals a crap ton of damage with those charges, who is going to go blasting. But she right here might actually want to use those for Excels and maybe use a really powerful Doppel. We'll have to see how strong the Doppel is. That's for the how good is Mitsune video that's going to come up soon. So yeah, that was that. Basically nothing else to talk about. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hit the subscribe button, ring the bell, and I'll see you guys next time.